Her full album will be released later on this year, but her two singles are already sending waves through the music industry. That singer and songwriter Simone Roets has just released two hit singles, "Dans Die Donker," and as well as "Ongerep," alongside Joshua Nadi Reën. Roets, who currently resides in Brisbane, Australia, joins us now via Zoom to tell us more. Very good morning to you, Simone. Thank you so much for joining us. Welcome to Morning Live.
Good morning, Simpiwe. It's lovely to be here.
Now, Simone, take us back to where it all started for you. When and where did your relationship with music start?
So, Simone, for me, I think music came a bit later. So after school, I went and studied law at the University of Pretoria. And I was surrounded with a bunch of creative people. You know, those people who always just pick up their guitars and start playing and writing. And I think that's where it started for me. I started sort of writing music and also playing guitar, and I think guitar has always been my means to write music, but never Afrikaans. So I've always written in English, was really involved with a lot of churches with their worship. Yeah. And then, yeah, we moved to Brisbane in 2016.
Okay.
I don't know what happened, but I think it was there that I just felt I wanted to start writing in Afrikaans.
Okay. And what challenges or milestones has the musical journey presented you with?
That's a hard question. I think I don't really know what's going on in the music industry in South Africa. I know a little bit more now. But sometimes I think it's a good thing because you don't have a reference of, you know what people want to hear. So you just basically write and sing the stuff that you want to do. So I think that's been really freeing for me in that regard, that I haven't been around much. But challenges definitely is getting out of your head and realizing that, you know, you can't care too much about what people think. You just got to do your thing and let people decide if they like it or not.
Yes, yes.
Don't try to decide for them, yeah.
True. Now take us through your single, "Dans Die Donker." Tell us more about this song and what the significance is of its title.
Yeah, so "Dans in die Donker," it's not a love song. It's not about dancing with someone. It's basically about us, all of us, going through tough times, and it's inevitable for all of us to go through those seasons where it just feel like life's not working really well for us. And I think it's trying to find a way to not ask so many questions as to why these things are happening to us, but rather just focus on how to get through it and get through it with a smile and get through it with joy in your heart, knowing that this is part of life. Life isn't perfect. So that's basically where "Dans in die Donker" is from, and that's the inspiration is, literally dancing through those dark times.
Now, Simone, how would you describe the sound on this project?
Interesting question, Simone. I think all the songs are a bit different. There's definitely a bit of a singer-songwriter feel. So all of them sort of start with that because I wrote them on acoustic guitar. But then there's a cinematic feel that sort of goes towards. So it really starts down. And then I think there's a lot going on vocally. There's no real inspiration from this side that I use, but Duncan Lawrence, Brandon Lake, Amanda Cook has been real, I think, inspiration sound-wise.
Yeah.
But yeah, people can expect a lot of vocal harmonies, vocal ad-libs. We spent a lot of time in the studio on those things. And I think every song is a bit different in its sound.
Okay. Now speak to us about working with Joshua Nadi Reën on the single "Ongerep." And how did that come about and what the inspiration behind the song is?
So "Ongerep" is, I wrote it while I was in Brisbane, and then had Joshua Nadi Reën in mind to sing it with me, but wasn't sure if he'd be keen. So I literally sent him a demo of just my vocals and piano on the song. So his wife went to school with me, so it wasn't like I didn't have that connection at all. And I do know people in the music industry, especially some of the alternative indie artists. So I just sent him a text message with the song and said, "Hey, I was hoping that you could sing this with me as a duet. Would you be keen?" So, and he basically just replied and said it would be an honor. So that's how our relationship came about. And it's been such a pleasure working with him in studio, and just there's just such a flow, and he's really organic in his approach to music. Nothing is forced. So we could just find ways of who sings what, which part, and
Sure.
The song just morphed into something awesome at the end. And yeah, he's such a friend now, and a friend and a mentor to me. He's played at my pre-launch a week ago. So yeah, grateful that he could be part of this project. The song ONGEREP basically means untouched. Like in the context of nature, it means untouched. And the song is about humanity and how we are all actually a little bit broken, I think. And it's sort of knowing that we aren't perfect, and living in that way, and also treating other people with grace and empathy. And so, yeah, so the song just came about. I think the older I get, the more I realize that everyone I meet has a story, and never to judge on it for how they act or how they do life, and just have grace. So I think that's sort of where the song came about is, and how do we get to that place where we don't have all the fake and all the pretenses? I feel life is full of that at the moment. So I think that song is sort of like a, let's get back to that untouched version of ourselves that's not fake.
And it seems like you had so much fun producing this album. So what were the highlights of working on this project, and how has their response been?
So I think the highlight for me is definitely the time writing these songs, but then also the time in the studio with my producer Yati De Beer from Artisty Productions. We've just had so much fun in the studio with especially harmonies and vocal stuff, and just awesome little elements in the production of the songs. I think that's definitely been a highlight for me, just the time spent in the studio. And I'm actually quite sad that we're pretty much done with it all at this point. So I think that's been a highlight for me, and definitely working with other musicians and other creatives along the way. Like the Adi, who does my videos, and literally just everyone involved in the project. You made such good friends. And we're currently in South Africa, and we're gonna stay. So so I think the highlight was coming back and then also sending these songs out to Afrikaans people who I haven't seen a lot in the past 5 years, but then realizing that these are actually the people that I'm writing for. So I think, highlights definitely been time in the studio and just process of creating music, of writing and then creating a song to put out there.
All right. Now, Simone, speak to us about working alongside Yeti De Beer of Artistry Productions, and what lessons have come from working alongside him?
Yeah, I think Yeti his musicality is really on another level. How he hears certain things. And I think I can learn so much from him just by the way that he produces and sitting next to him. And I think with Yati, it's just his way of sort of letting the artist be the artist. But then him coming in and almost taking what you bring and just making it a little bit more palatable for a commercial audience, but without taking from... taking anything from who you are as a person and what you wrote. So I think he's brilliant in that regard to take my songs and keep them Simone, but then also allow other people to hear that. I think, he's just a brilliant musician, and he would hear harmonies that I would never hear in my life. And then he would play them on the piano. He's like, oh, this is the harmony. And I'm like, how do you hear that? How do you hear those things? So I think he's just amazing with vocal harmonies too. So there's a good synergy between the two of us. I think that has been such a blessing throughout this project. I learn from literally everyone I work with. So he's a brilliant producer and just a friend.
Great stuff. So how do your fans follow you?
So Instagram, Simone_Roets_, and then on Facebook, it's Simone Roets Music. And then you can also subscribe on my YouTube channel, which is just Simone Roets, and you'll find the music video for Dans in die Donker and ONGEREP there, and some behind-the-scenes videos of making the album and all of that. And all the songs are on the platforms. So, that's it.
Fantastic stuff. Lovely chatting to you, Simone. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks, Mpiwe. Lovely chatting to you guys. Have a wonderful day.
Great stuff. Thank you. That was singer and songwriter Simone Roets taking us through her musical journey, as well as her two singles, Dans in Donker, as well as Ongerep, alongside Joshua Nadirian.